My garbage person is Candace Owens. What? Candace Owens, who won't let any kind of conspiracy theory or opportunity to put her face on camera go to waste. She has very obviously, the same way she came up with Blexit as a cool new slogan, she has a new adaptation of QAnon that she really, really wants Laura Ingraham to come around on. Here's how that went down.
You are absolutely right. And let me also say, and conservatives need to start saying this more, QAnon has now transformed into BlueAnon, right? This is a Democrat run. They are coming up with conspiracy theories and saying that all of these things are going on so that they can rush through policies and push through policies and say, because there's some obscure threat. They're not providing any details regarding this threat. And let me tell you, as a DC resident, it looks like we are under a military occupation. This is the most popular president in American history. Why does he need to erect all of these walls around the White House? Shouldn't he be able to just simply walk down the street and shake hands because he's the most loved and popular and most voted for president, more popular than Barack Obama in 2008? And yet you have the Capitol under lockdown and under a military occupation.
My brain is bleeding from that last point. I know that that's not the point that you want to focus on, but the idea that because he's popular, right wingers don't want to assassinate him is madness. Just
insane.
Madness. But go on.
So all of this, the point that she was making was essentially she wants to make a point about why the Capitol was locked down and why there was essentially has essentially been locked down and why there was no you know, legislative session due to the threat of some kind of attack on the Capitol on March 4th, right? Mm-hmm. So that was what she's pointing out. And she says, no, it's the equivalent of QAnon. It's not QAnon, it's become BlueAnon because it's the Democrats and the president who are coming up with these fake conspiracy theories that they're using to shut everything down. And the response to that is, well, I think you just alienated most of your audience because you're calling them insane. So I think it's just a bad rhetorical move on their part. And then do I need to remind you why they are locking these things down? Now, I'm fine. I totally will have a conversation about like unnecessary reactions to attacks. But like, do I have to remind you why they have locked down the Capitol? And how it's not just some ethereal potential threat of violence. Do you remember this? Like, it isn't an ethereal threat of attack. This is like those same crazies pointed to the 4th as a time to attack. So yep, it's locked down. And again, the point that you made, which is just because of more people like him than liked other presidents, doesn't mean that no one hates him. In fact, in the tribal environment that you and the host of the show you're on helped to create, it means that anyone who's not for that president is more likely to be avidly, unhingedly against that president in a way that could lead to violence. But the truth is, like, I will have that open conversation, that conversation about what is too much of a reaction in terms of taking away people's civil liberties. But
I agree. No, but
she doesn't want to have that earnest.
Clear on that. Like, yeah, is everything that is already legal. You don't need any new laws. We totally agree on that. That's not, I don't think, a question. The idea though that, like, if Biden is popular mostly, it doesn't mean that there aren't still threats against him, particularly when, like, that's even when you ignore the fact that a predisposition to political violence is not evenly distributed across the population. It is 100% clustered in the group that I would say 100% does not like Joe Biden. But even if it did, like, it's the idea of trying to say, well, QAnon is getting kind of embarrassing. It's like so many of our people believe it and it makes us look like kooks. And now we're going to say it's BlueAnon. It's the Democrats that are behind it, but not being said in a way that, like, she, and I mentioned this in the pre-show, she's not saying, hey, people watching Laura Ingraham who believe in QAnon, because definitely there's a bunch that do. She's not saying you guys need to wake up because the Democrats are manipulating you. She doesn't want them to stop believing these things. She just wants to somehow imply that QAnon is a Democrat thing, that it's not the right that's crazy, it's the Dems that are crazy. In the same way that Tucker Carlson, every night on his show, he's saying he's trying to come up with some sort of conspiracy theory that Democrats believe that's equivalent to literally millions of Americans thinking that Chrissy Teigen eats babies to get their hormones. Like, they're all desperate to apologize for how big QAnon has gotten. They just haven't come up with a really good way to do that. That's the best that she can come up with, and it's just not very good.
And the worst part is they're just gonna repeat it over and over again.
Oh yeah, she's gonna try to get it trending.
Yeah, over BlueAnon. But it's like, it's like gate to everything. You're adding gate, but Watergate was the name of a hotel. You're gonna say deflate gate. Like, no, gate is not a suffix that means scandal.
Scandal.
The same way that a thon is not a suffix that means a lot of something.
I actually thought that one. I did think that one. Anyway, good garbage person though. We don't often bring her up, but when we do, probably gonna be in this context. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.